Okay, so my name is Alec, and I'm from Milan, Italy, and I've been here already for like 10 years. Some of the interests now in science is to build tissues, so build organs, if we can replace organs or tissues with basically live samples. So if I think when I was 6 or 7, if you would ask me, what do you want to do when you grow up? I remember my brother wanted to be an actor, and I always wanted to be an inventor, whatever that means. You know, I love the Lego pieces, and I wanted to build these spaceships and everything, and little I knew that inventor really doesn't exist as a profession. But the closest thing is probably an engineer or a scientist. So I don't come from a scientific background, at least none of my family, none of my parents are scientists. And my brother ended up being a manager, product manager. So very completely passed. I think I'm the anomaly of the family.
But it sounds very different space.
On a day-to-day basis, I like to use, probably Richard Feynman's quote would be the best, like the pleasure of finding things out, I think is what gives me a little joy. I mean, this is the only profession that gives you the intellectual creativity and freedom that no other profession would allow you to, would give you. I mean, so I do have a desk somewhere. Actually, I probably have multiple desks somewhere. I'm never at the desk, really. It's a very flexible kind of environment. So the fact that we deal with living materials, like cells, that means we don't have a 9-to-5. Because, and you cannot really take the weekend off, because it's not that during the weekend your cells are time out, will stop living. So you have to come and like feed your tissues and make them alive. You don't stop eating during weekends, right? So for instance, in my particular case, I work a lot with mammary and prostates. And I try to reconstruct these tissues in three dimensions in vitro, and so in a dish. There's a lot of different rooms with a lot of different expensive machines that you need to use to make these experiments. So you're not always in the same location, you're not in a cubicle, which I'm allergic to. So I don't think every day is the same. And then you set up a different experiment, or you do and you work with a collaborator about something. You're not always in the same spot. So I like that a lot too. It's fun. Okay, how are you gonna conjugate the snark one to the maltodextrin beads? Most of the times you fail at experiments. Like, that's just the nature of the business. It's hard to do something new. We're really good at doing stuff that we know how to do. It's easy. But if you're doing something new that nobody has ever done before, you have no idea exactly what is the proper way of doing it. If you go and you're interested in research and want to develop something new or something that has never done or discover something new, don't make your failures and frustrations and roadblocks prevent you from going that road, because those are inevitable. The way I actually see it is a little bit like the Far West of back in the days, you know, like these life sciences things. It's like nobody has any idea what's going on down at the molecular level, at the cellular level, absolutely clueless. So it is like a Far West. You walk in, you have your like horse, your hat, your whip, which would be like your machines, your instruments, and they're tumbleweeds and nobody has any idea what's going on. So you're like going in and you're conquering. It might go wrong. You might be like walking in the desert and you're just clueless. You'll never find water for a long, long time. But sometimes you'll find gold.